Hey guys, I'm Dithi Sikin, and in today's video, I'm going to be talking about makeup products that I don't have too many of. Usually, I am recommending products that I have, and I'm recommending products to you guys. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about products that I don't have too many of, and probably you guys can give me your recommendation. Today's video is about products that I don't really have too many of in my makeup collection, and I have a lot of products in my makeup collection, but not these. So let's get started. I have written it down right here so that I don't miss out anything. Let's get started. So the first product I've written down is lip gloss. For some reason, I'm a matte lipstick lover. I love the look of matte lipsticks on my lips and I love how it looks. But I think over time, I've started to like how glossy lips look as well. Like I like glosses. I like how it looks. But I don't really have too many of those. I just have this one. This is the Kiko Milano lip gloss. Like it comes on this side. There's a liquid lipstick and this lip gloss on one side. Other than that, I mean, besides this, I think I have just one or two lip glosses. I can't even find those anymore. I had one from ColourPop, which I really liked, but I think that went rancid. So pretty much no lip gloss in my collection, turns out. Yeah. So let me know. What are your favorite lip glosses? I would definitely like to try. I am looking to try the e.l.f. Lip gloss in the shade Praline. For some reason, that is calling my name, but that's out of stock most of the time. So let me know what is your favorite lip gloss, and I would really like to try that out. And then something else that I don't really have too many of are lip liners. I can't seem to get maximum use out of lip liners. I have just the K-Beauty lip liners, some Essence lip liners. I have like 5 lip liners, I think. K-Beauty, Essence, Nykaa, and Miss Claire lip liners. So these are the only ones that I have, and I don't tend to use them as much, especially to line my lips or to mix it in when I'm using like a lighter shade just to outline my lips. I don't really find the need to do that. If at all a shade is too light, I just mix it up a little bit with a darker shade and I just use it. And I don't really find the need to line my lips. Maybe I should, especially when lipsticks do bleed or when you're wearing like darker shades, but yeah, that's it. I don't really have a lot of those. I feel like they are a little bit hard. They tug and pull. Some of them, the K-Beauty lip liners are really nice. They are like, they glide on like butter, but I just feel like they are priced equivalently to a lipstick itself. So I would rather buy a lipstick that I would get more use out of. So that's my thought process, but maybe I should buy some really good lip liners. Again, you guys are going to help me with that. And then some other products that I don't really have too many of are bronzers and contour products. I have like the face palette from Sugar. I have some, okay? I don't really have too many of that, but I have some of those. And even those, I don't really use them on a daily basis. I don't really use them too much like other YouTubers and Instagrammers and influencers and beauty. You see people use them on a daily basis. They use so much of it. And I feel like I literally get no use out of it almost, most of the times. I like to use it just to like on the outer perimeters of my face, but not so much on my cheekbone, because I feel like it makes my cheeks look a little bit hollow, especially like contour products, something that has a little bit more gray undertone to it. Bronzers, these days I am getting away with using it, but you guys can see I do have a slender face. I have a skinny face. So I feel like it sometimes makes me look like that. So I'm not a very big fan of that. These days I am getting around to using it a little bit more, but a little bit on a lighter hand. During my wedding time, the makeup artist taught me something about reverse contouring, where she said you can make your face look a little bit like chubbier with contour itself, but you have to do it the other way. Like you have to not contour it the usual way, something like that. But I forgot what she actually did, and I tried to look it up. Nobody ever mentions about reverse contouring because everybody wants just the cheekbones. Nobody wants to look like you have cheeks. So that's that. And then some more products that I don't really have too many of are eyebrow products. I don't really fill them up on a daily basis. I have my Sugar eyebrows pencils. Some, okay, I don't really have too many of this. These are not products I don't absolutely have, but I have few. But compared to other products, like I have so many lipsticks, so many foundations, so many concealers, I don't really have these in that number. And the reason I don't really have a lot of eyebrow products is because I have pretty full brows and they're not evenly shaped, and it takes me a while, and it takes me time and it takes precision to just get them evenly, even looking. And some products work for me. Sometimes it just looks like two cockroaches are chasing each other or like fighting with each other just to get that even thing. And then it's a big ruckus. So I just prefer not filling in my brows. I like the look of some people's eyebrows when it's filled in, looks all really nice. But I don't really have the skill for it and the patience to fill in my brows. And same goes with eyebrow gel. I don't really have it. I really like those soapy brows, like the ones that they make the hair stand up. I am looking to buy those, but I don't really have even one product for that. And then some other products that I don't really have are eyeliners. I have like 3 to 4 eyeliners, liquid liners, and that's pretty much it, because you guys have seen the number of times I've used eyeliners. I don't really use too many of those. One, I feel like they are really expensive, some of those, to get those MAC jet black pigmented eyeliners, long lasting eyeliners. And the other thing that I feel like is, in the affordable range, most of them have like that glossy sheen, and then they flake off from your lips, and then they fake lips. Okay, all the time talking about lipsticks, they flake off from your eyes over time and they just look bad. So suggest some good affordable eyeliners that look matte, and those sketch eyeliners. And one more thing why I don't really like is, if it is in that sketch eyeliner form, I really like that. But if it's like this, where you have to apply it, shaky hands won't let me get that even line. It just goes haphazard. And sometimes, you know, the eyeshadow would look so good, blended, all perfect, and this eyeliner will just wreck it. So that's the reason I don't really have too many of those. But if you have good sketch eyeliner recommendations from the affordable range that is matte, pigmented, let me know. And same goes with eyelash glue. I just have 2 eyelash glues. One is from PAC and the other one is the Duo eyelash glue. The Duo one dried up, it's gone. So I just use the PAC lash fixer. That's all I have. I'm looking to buy the Huda Beauty lash glue from the longest time, but it's always sold out. So that is all I have. And if the PAC one gives up on me, I actually don't really have an eyelash glue. Then something else that I don't really have, that a lot of you guys request me to talk about, are lip tints. For some reason, I never found the need to go out and buy a lip tint, because if I needed like a tint kind of a feel, I used to do that with my lipstick itself. But now I'm intrigued with some lip tints, which I will be buying and reviewing for you guys. For all of you guys asking me about lip tints, it's coming up really soon. I'm going to buy a couple of those, but it's going to take me a while, you know. I have a set budget, a certain month to buy makeup, and that's all I stick to. So I have to juggle in between all of this for that. So I will be buying that pretty soon and reviewing it for you guys. Some of the popular lip tints that I want to try out. But otherwise, I just use the L'Oreal liquid lipstick, the one that feels like a hybrid of a liquid lipstick and a tint, and that's all I use on a daily basis. And I just use my lipstick, you know, using it with a light hand, and that's the job for me. So lip tints I don't have. And another product that I don't really have too many of are BB creams. I was never a BB cream person. I've never used it that much. I did go ahead and buy the Pond's BB cream, the Garnier one, the Nykaa BB cream, and the Biotic BB creams. But I feel like I can do that if I really want to look like I have a little bit of makeup on. I just use my foundation with a light hand. So the point of BB creams, I don't really understand. I know they are easy on the pocket, but they just have one shade. So that's the reason I don't really buy a lot of BB creams. And especially for me, when I'm filming videos, I like something a little bit with more coverage, with medium coverage or medium high coverage, because that's what looks nice when you have lights on. And on a daily basis, I don't really use any foundation, concealer, nothing of that sort. And especially with masks, I don't even use concealer. At least back in the day, I used to use concealer underneath my eyes and around my mouth. But now, because this is sealed, no concealer, just moisturizer, sunscreen, my serum, my skincare. That's enough for me, and just kajal on a daily basis. So I don't really have a lot of those as well. Not so surprisingly. I've mentioned this and I've been pretty vocal about it. Like, I don't really have a lot of those. So these were all the products that I could think of from the back of my head about products I don't really have a lot of, especially like with a bigger collection of makeup that I have. So let me know your favorite recommendations for any such products, like for lip liners, lip gloss, anything that you really like. Let me know in the comment section down below. I'd be really interested to, and it'd be really helpful for me. I mean, like, I really like it when you guys give me suggestions, and it always works out. It's amazing. So I am waiting for your suggestions. So yeah, let me know what are the products that you don't really have in your makeup collection, what you don't really have too much of, or you don't have at all. I would be interested to read those as well. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Give this video a big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that you're notified every time I upload a new video. And see you guys in my next one. Bye.